Let's calculate the molar solubility of calcium fluoride. If the Ksp value for calcium fluoride is 3.9 times 10 to the negative 11th at 25 degrees Celsius. The first step is to write the dissolution equation for calcium fluoride. So solid calcium fluoride will dissolve in solution to form aqueous calcium 2 plus ions and fluoride anions. And to balance that out, we need to make sure and include a 2 in front of the fluoride anions. The next step is to set up an ice table, where I stands for initial concentration, C stands for the change in concentration, and E stands for equilibrium concentration. Before any of the solid calcium fluoride dissolves, the initial concentrations of calcium 2 plus ions and fluoride anions in solution is 0. So we can go ahead and put a 0 in here for the initial concentration of the ions in solution. Some of the calcium fluoride will dissolve, and we don't know how much, so I like to represent that by writing minus x on the ice table, where x is the concentration of calcium fluoride that dissolves. Looking at the mole ratios, it's a 1-to-1 mole ratio between calcium fluoride and calcium 2 plus ions. So if we're losing x for the concentration of calcium fluoride, we must be gaining x for the concentration of calcium 2 plus ions. And since it's a 1-to-2 mole ratio for calcium 2 plus ions to fluoride anions, if we're gaining plus x for calcium 2 plus, we must gain plus 2x for fluoride anions. So the equilibrium concentration of calcium 2 plus ions is 0 plus x, or just x, and the equilibrium concentration of fluoride anions would be 0 plus 2x, or just 2x. The next step is to write the Ksp expression from the balanced equation. So Ksp is equal to the concentration of calcium 2 plus ions, and since there's a coefficient of 1 in the balanced equation, it's the concentration of calcium 2 plus ions raised to the first power, times the concentration of fluoride anions, and since there's a coefficient of 2 in the balanced equation, it's the concentration of fluoride anions raised to the second power. Pure solids are not included in equilibrium constant expressions, so we're going to leave calcium fluoride out of the Ksp expression. The concentration of ions in our Ksp expression are equilibrium concentrations. Therefore, we can plug in x for the equilibrium concentration of calcium 2 plus and 2x for the equilibrium concentration of fluoride anions. We can also plug in the Ksp value for calcium fluoride. So that would give us 3.9 times 10 to the negative 11th is equal to x times 2x squared. Next, we need to solve for x. So 3.9 times 10 to the negative 11th is equal to x times 2x squared. Well, 2x squared is equal to 4x squared times x is equal to 4x cubed. So to solve for x, we need to divide both sides by 4. And then take the cube root of both sides. So we'd take the cube root of the left side and the cube root of x cubed. That gives us x is equal to 2.1 times 10 to the negative fourth. And looking at our ice table, x represents the equilibrium concentration of calcium 2 plus ions. So 2.1 times 10 to the negative fourth molar is the equilibrium concentration of calcium 2 plus ions. For the fluoride anions, the equilibrium concentration is 2x. So 2 times 2.1 times 10 to the negative fourth is 4.2. Let me go ahead and write that down here. 4.2 times 10 to the negative fourth molar for the equilibrium concentration of fluoride anions. Our goal was to calculate the molar solubility of calcium fluoride, and molar solubility refers to the concentration of our salt that dissolved to form a saturated solution at equilibrium. So if x refers to the concentration of calcium 2 plus ions at equilibrium, looking at our mole ratios, that's also the concentration of calcium fluoride that dissolved. Therefore, 2.1 times 10 to the negative fourth molar is also the molar solubility of calcium fluoride. Technically, at a constant temperature of 25 degrees, the concentration of a solid doesn't change, and so you'll see most textbooks not put in minus x on the ice table. I like to just put it in, though, to remind me that x in this case does refer to the molar solubility.